Welcome to the lesson on similar quadrilaterals. In this lesson, we will discuss the conditions that make quadrilaterals similar and how we can use similarity to solve problems. So by definition, similarity is a condition of having the same shape but not the same size. This is different from congruent, where everything is the same. So if I want to go ahead and illustrate similarity, I can start by drawing two trapezoids. I draw a small trapezoid, A, B, C, D, and I can go ahead and give you lengths for the sides. The two sides are 6, the small side is 4, and the other side is 10. I can draw a large trapezoid from here, label it W, X, Y, and Z, and I can go ahead and tell you that these two will be similar, 12 and 12 on the sides, 8 on top, and a big 20 on the bottom. Now, in order for two things to be similar, they must have congruent corresponding angles. So if my two angles on the small trapezoid, two bottom angles are something, whatever that measure is, two bottom angles have to be that same measure, and the same thing goes for the top angles. So my arcs indicate as such. So now I can discuss the ratios between the sides. If I take the two sides of these trapezoids, they're going to have to match up and give me the same value. So I look at it in the similarity statement. A, B, C, D is similar to W, X, Y, Z. So let's look at some of these. Let's look at side A, B. It corresponds to W, X. So 6 over 12. I look at B, C, which is 4. It corresponds to X, Y. So 4 over 8. I can keep going and look at side A, D, 10. How it corresponds to W, Z, 20. If I look at the math, 6 over 12 equals 4 over 8 equals 10 over 12. They all will end up being 1/2. So I can take this similarity and I can use it in order to find missing sides of various shapes. So I'll draw two new quadrilaterals, one with sides 8 and 10, and I'll draw a smaller but similar version of it with sides 5 and a small side I don't know, X. So how can I use similarity and use ratios to find that missing side X? Well, I can do so with a process called cross multiplication. So I'll start the problem by using the side I do know, 8, over the side I don't know, X, and then making it equal to a ratio of the two sides I do know, 10 over 5. I'll then cross multiply 8 times 5 equaling 40, and 10 times X equaling 10X, and now I can use algebra to solve for X, so X equals 4. The missing side of that quadrilateral I did not know is 4, and I was able to use similarity in order to find it. In the same way, I can check for similarity in quadrilaterals that I may not be sure about. So looking at two what might be similar quadrilaterals, I can look at their sides, 10 and 5, look at the smaller one whose sides are 6 and 3, and then determine if those two sides are indeed similar. So if I try 10 over 6, will it be equal to 5 over 3? And of course, even before I can do all this, I must make sure, are the angles even the same? Because if my angles are not the same, I won't have similarity even to begin with. So let's practice some of these problems. Are the following rhombi similar? So I take my first rhombus with sides 9, 8, and 4, and then I'll look at and determine if it's similar to a smaller rhombus with sides 7, 6, and 3. Now I only need to check two of the pairs of sides, so let's do 9 over 7, and let's see if it'll be equal to 8 over 6. Even though I could try 4 over 3, as long as one of the pairs is unequal, that'll already go ahead and disprove similarity for our case. So I look at 9 over 7, it gives me 1.28. Then I look at 8 over 6, and it gives me 1.33. Since those two corresponding sides are not equal to each other, our two rhombi are not similar. So let's go back to another find the missing side problem. I have a parallelogram with sides X and 6, and I have a smaller parallelogram with sides 5 and 2. So as I carefully set up the problem, X over 5 will be equal to the other corresponding pair, 6 over 2. I cross multiply. X times 2 gives me 2X, and 6 times 5 gives me 30. Divide both sides by 2, and X gives me 15. So the big side of that big quadrilateral is 15. In the last problem, I can expand similarity to finding perimeter. Let's say that I have one rectangle with the side 7, another rectangle with one of the sides 4, And I happen to know that the big rectangle's perimeter is 30. So can I set up ratios to find the perimeter of my small rectangle? And we'll call it x for now. So 30, the perimeter I know over 7, the side, equals x, the perimeter I don't know, over 4, the side of the small rectangle that I do know. As I cross multiply, 120 equals 7x, and I can finish up by dividing both sides by 7. So x equals 17.1. The connection with similarity, especially when it comes to quadrilaterals, is very strong, as similarity helps define blueprints and models in architecture.